we present a novel method for authoring landscapes with plants and animals. Previous methods modeled vegetation only, without taking animals into account. However, the impact of the animals is important, as they carve clearings and trails in the vegetation. Our algorithm takes as input a terrain and its climatic conditions, and it outputs a set of density maps for each species, as well as a trail map. This is then used to instantiate the ecosystem during on-the-fly exploration. We order the species by food chain dominance, plants, herbivores, and carnivores. We have developed a new data structure called the resource access graph, which encodes the interactions between animals at different food chain levels. The graph nodes represent resources for a given species, and the edges encode the accessibility and the traveling time between the nodes. We analyze the terrain to compute the environmental resources needed by the plants as the first level of the resource access graph. In particular, we compute the ground moisture, illumination, temperature, and the user can also input a supplementary map indicating the soil type. These maps are converted to the graph structure by identifying each cell as a node. The plants compete for the available environmental resources, and this is calculated in a node-by-node manner. This results in a set of spatially connected nodes, each one embedding the plant density for all the species. The animals cannot move indefinitely, and we restrict animal mobility when computing the next levels of the food chain. We compute an accessibility map for plants and natural obstacles, segmenting the domain in species-specific confinement areas. To do so, we remove all the inaccessible nodes and rerun a fluid fill algorithm on the graph. We can then recursively compute the resource access graph up to the top of the food chain. At a given level, the species compete for resources. We designed a new competition algorithm which unifies the treatment of plants and animals. We first choose the species whose addition would most closely match the user-specified proportions. We then compute the confinement region that fulfills its needs and increase the density of this species in the selected area before iterating until consumption of the resources. We use the resource access graph to modify the terrain and the plant densities, adding clearing and trails. We also sample this graph to compute daily plannings of animals for on-the-fly exploration. For each herd, we incrementally sample new activities based on the needs of the species, while ensuring that essential activities are represented. We repeat this process until the planning for a day is fully constructed. This allows us to interactively follow activities of the animals during live exploration. Now, let's explore an ecosystem created from real-world data. Here, we can see the trails left by wild animals, which provide precious information about the resources of the ecosystem. Of course, the animals can also be seen directly in their daily activities. For example, we can observe a herd of deer grazing, or a lone bear looking for its next meal.